talk, we spoke about the agenda, the purpose. And today we'll be looking at the other side of motivation, because usually Allah in the Quran and also find in the Sunnah of the Prophet there are two kinds of motivation. One motivation is for us, inshallah, to move towards paradise. And the other motivation for us is to work hard so that we avoid his punishment. Now I'm going to share with you a very interesting story that may be also part of motivation to us. And for us to ponder through as we go in this blessed month of Ramadan, which is full of Allah and full of opportunities. Now, this story was related to one of the weighty writer by the name of Rahimahullah. So the writer was leaving behind in his writing. He was trying to predict the time in which, not actually predict, to imagine the time in which he will die. So when he dies, what will be the kind of situation which commonly we also experience? So he's telling it to us and to remind us that after that period of death, what will remain with us? And it's very interesting. It may be common to us. We always experience it. But it's a reminder also of motivation that we need really to work a lot in this Ramadan. So he says that, and in his writing, that when I am on the bed, in my deathbed, I'm sure so many people will be around me, my relatives, my friends, and they see me dying. And he says, from my deathbed I could see how helpless they are. When I was strong and moving around, if I need a cup of water, people will give it to me. I need anything, I have a lot of helpers around me. My wife, my children, my friends, I have so many helps, even the maids are around. But at this point in time, everybody is helpless. They cannot save my situation. Then my ruh leaves my body, my soul leaves my body. And sometimes when we die, my jaws are open, my eyes are open. Now my friends come, they close my eyes, and they put my jaws together, according to him. And then the first thing they begin to do is, they start removing my clothes. He says, let alone the ones which I have in the wardrobe, which I used to change every day, one after the other. But now the first thing that leaves me is my cloth is no longer my clothes. They remove it and cover me with just white sheet of bed sheet. Sorry, white bed sheet. So after they cover me with the sheet of cloth, then they take me away to bathe me, getting me ready for my janazah. And as they prepare me, they take me to the mosque. And everybody is now gathered. Some of them sacrifice their time, sacrifice their job to come and pray for me. He said, the first thing I lose is my name. I'm no longer called a professor, or a dancery, or a dato, or a don. Suddenly people start calling me the Mayyit, the Janaz. Let us pray to the Janaz. I have lost the name already. And subhanAllah, interestingly, many of us in dunya, we fight for this title. We write articles, we want to become professors. And we are really struggling, we want to be called Dato, Tansri, Don, Sharifa, I don't know what, all the other names. And one scholar says, we do not even struggle to get the title of Akhira. Because in Akhirah, no one will be called as a professor. Allah will call the word Hamadun. Those who say is Alhamdulillah, not to Allah. Zakirun, those who remember Allah a lot. Shuhada, Musaddun. These are the names that will be called me. But I don't know how many of us struggle to get that title of this Akhirah. Why, when we die, this title reached us according to this scholar. Now they start calling Mayyid. Bring the Mayyid, let us pray to the Mayyid. And even the Imam, when he says, okay, let us pray to this Mayyid, he lost the name. When they carry the Janazah, they also say, come please, let us take the Mayyid. Again, you are Mayyid. They put us in Qabr, again, the word Mayyid is used. He lost the title. So he says, they take me to my new home. They remove me from the home which I was with my family members. Now I have a different destination. It is no longer the sofa sense that I used to enjoy. It's no longer the bed which after I come, I go and relax. But I'm given just a small room, enough just for me to lie on my side. Then he says, who are my dear friends? Where is the electricity? Where is the water? So he raises those questions. Once they covered me, he says, everybody leaves me and goes behind. The same people who were around me while I was on the deathbed, nobody's around me, according to this scholar. So he says, my relatives come home. They begin sorting my things. This was his shoes. These were his clothes. Check my bank account, how much is left. This was his car he used to drive. So all these were checked. And then they start giving them away. Then he says, the chapter is now closed on me. The chapter of dunya is closed and now begins the chapter of akhirah. That is why Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu says, adding to what the scholar he says, and he was speaking to the people of the Qabr. He says, Ya Ahl al-Qubur, Sayyidina Ali was addressing them. He says, Inna al-amwala qad qusimat. The wealth which you left behind has already been given out. The car is given out, the bungalow is already shared, everything is shared. And he says, وَإِنَّ الْأَزْوَاجَ فَتَزَوَّجْنَا يَا سَلَامُ. The husband has already got a new wife, and the wife has got a new husband, if they are young. And then he says, Sayyidina Ali says, those al-Qubur, if you ask them, what is the best provision that you are taking with you now? Because if you travel, you need a provision, you need a handbag. فَقَالُ إِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادٍ التَّقْوَى. They will tell you the best suitcase now I'm carrying is التَّقْوَى. It is my amal that I'm carrying with you. So once they close the chapter, my dear brothers and sisters, what is left is now our amal, our salah, our salafat, silat rahim, being good with your neighbors. And this is the language which is understood in the Qabr. The Quran that we read becomes our friends. So, if we know that everything that we enjoy in this dunya remains as they are, why we should wonder that there is no time left for us. We need to rush. Who knows, this may be our last Ramadan. We may be the person that the scholar is talking about. And then he says, after I am in the Qabr, the friends will feel a bit uneasy, very sorrowful. Some of them will say, oh, Mr. Oh, poor guy. Then after some time they forget. The relatives will cry for a few months. Then they go back to normal. My relatives maybe for 1 year, they feel sad. After that, life begins as normal. My job is taken by others. The world continues to operate the way it used to operate. And I have not affected the world a single inch of it. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah is so Rahim to us, He's full of Rahmah. And sometimes we don't look at the Rahmah of Allah. We focus on the few bad ones and forget that there is so much ni'mah in Ramadan that we need to capitalize on and build up our amal. We have to be regular in our salawat, reading Quran, Qiyamul Layl is coming by. And some of these, and of course Laylatul Qadr is already on the way coming, inshallah, in the last 10 days. So, can we, subhanAllah, try to rethink? When I look everywhere, and I'm going to conclude, that our Ramadan, subhanAllah, if I may conclude, is so much about friendship, which is good, but it should not be at the expense of our spirituality. It's so much also about makan, makan. And the irony is, we have stayed until 7 o'clock without eating or drinking. Why is it suddenly when it is time for iftar, we become crazy? This I don't understand. Even sometimes when the imam is still correcting the microphone, kak, kak, already the water is gone. What is this? Still the microphone is being corrected. Wallah, you cannot imagine. That's why the Prophet says, Man saba Ramadan iman and ihtisaban. Wallahi, that strong belief that Ya Allah, it is for your sake. Not to think, oh, I lost 24 hours. Now I need to replace. How much does it take, wallahi, to wait for Adhan to finish and take this beautiful opportunity to make a sincere dua to Allah and say, Ya Rab, please give me istiqamah in your deen. Ya Rab, forgive me and my parents. Ya Rab, I'm asking the door for your rahmah. Ya Rab, Ya Rab. It will not take you 5 minutes. But suddenly, Allahu Akbar, already we're finished. And not only that, we want to eat until we go. Of course not Alhamdulillah. Why is not Alhamdulillah? It's not Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah is when you come, you sacrifice to Allah at that last minute and just come and pray for Him. Wallahi, I swear by Allah, you will do that, you will see the barakah in your food. You will eat with so much tranquility, so much peace of mind. Inside you, you will feel that you have really pleased Allah. But we are not there to please our makan, to please Allah. We are there to please Allah. Please, for God's sake, let us take the best. Every moment in Ramadan counts. Every moment counts. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if you knew a lot of rahmah and barakah in this month, you would wish that every month is Ramadan. Every month is Ramadan. Even in Laylatul Qadr, when the angels come, wallahi, the person who is sleeping, the angels will still go and say, Ameen. He's sleeping, he's not praying the Hajj. He is sleeping peacefully. Still, the blessing of the angels will go with them. See the rahmah of Allah in this month. So let us get all the best in this month. And may Allah really give us the best out of it. Allahumma taqabbal minna salatana. وصيامنا وقيامنا وقعودنا وتوبتنا يا إله الأولين والآخرين تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتوب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مغفورا وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.